Hey, Leopard Church, what an amazing time and season this is. First of all, I want to thank you for making the effort, transitioning in a matter of a week from coming in and fellowshipping together to turning everything that we do in the way of a community to an online community. So thankful and blessed and encouraged at your faithfulness in that. But we don't want to pretend that things haven't changed for you. We know they have. We know that in many ways your world has been turned upside down. You're fighting the battle, having everyone live in the house. Maybe your income, streams of income have been challenged or changed or altered or a loss of income. Maybe you're not sure what the future holds. Maybe you even have loved ones that are sick, and we believe that this is going to be sustained, that there's going to be some challenges, and the world has been turned upside down. But as you've heard us say before, and it's worth repeating, there are some things that don't change. Christ never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And our mission, Jesus has laid on our heart, and our vision hasn't changed. Our mission is to love God, love people, and fulfill the Great Commission. Our sense of vision is to become disciples who make disciples, to see Jesus proclaimed. You know, our values don't change. We believe that we are to live and to have our way by being in the presence of the glory of God that is profoundly seen in the gospel of God that results in us giving our life away. So we believe those things don't change. The things that might change is how we do that. So I wanted to spend a few moments, and we're going to be sending out notifications to you of what is the state of Lightbridge Church. Where are we in light of the changes that have occurred in you and the means and methodology for which God is calling us to meet our vision and our mission and our values, to do that, to be a community that makes disciples. So first of all, let me just say this. We've made the switch in one way to an online community, but that's not where it ends. I mean, we have online missional communities. We have online prayer on Monday. We have on Tuesday, we have online missional communities on Monday. We have word of the day throughout the course of the week. And then, of course, our services on Sunday. So that's beautiful. That's incredible. Don't forsake. We're asking you, what would we ask in switching everything to an online community? We'll make it a priority to meet. Hebrews 10 says, do not forsake the assembly together. This idea that I need you in my life and you need me in your life, together we are the body of Christ. And so we're saying, what is our commitment? What is the state of the church? Well, in light of COVID-19, we've switched to an online community. That's one way. But the other question that you'd be right to ask and we want to answer and address is, what is the state of church as it relates to our vision? Being a group of people who make disciples, who are disciples, who make disciples. And here's what we feel like God has laid on our heart. We feel like God has asked us as a leadership team, first of all, let's get on our knees, broken and respondent to the presence of Jesus Christ, that is being disciples. Let's be a leadership team that deepens our walk with you. That's why we're doing the new series, Heart of Worship. That's why we're driving prayer on Tuesday nights. We believe God is calling us all for this time, for such a time as this, to be disciples and make disciples is the be disciple component. For us to get into the Word of God deeper, richer, for us to cling to God in a deeper and richer way, for us to lead people to live with God in a deeper and richer, obedient way. So that's what we believe. God is calling us to take a deep breath, to ourselves as leaders, to find our focus on deepening our walk with Jesus Christ in broken repentance, and then to lead others to do the same. So we're starting our Disciple Nurture Act groups, and you'll see more about that in the course of the weeks to come. But it's a 16-week study that we're going to be really delving into growing in Christ together, this idea of being disciples. I want to read out of 2 Timothy chapter 2. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others as well. Share in the sufferings of a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No soldier gets entangled in civilian pursuits, since his aim is to please the one who enlisted him. I love this, because what it says is the basic nature of our vision to be disciples who make disciples begins with people who are not entangled in the worldly things, that we're going to stay in the Word of God, we're going to enrich our lives through prayer and the Word, we're going to gather together, and then we're going to gather in these groups. The means of how we're going to do that is going to be announced. It's coming to you. We're going to gather together, and for the next several weeks, in the midst of COVID-19, we are going to emphasize being disciples, and then we'll see how God moves in who make disciples. And so we're just praying that you would be a part of everything that is put on the table. I would remind you that We're still, another thing that's not changed, we're still supporting missionaries all over the country who need our support now more than ever, and missionaries all over the world. So if you haven't made a transition to online giving, that's where the resources go. Your prayers and your thoughts. You can join the mission of response to COVID-19 all over the world by being faithful and gathering and doing that, and then being a part of these Disciple Nurture at groups. In addition to that, what we're looking at, and you'll hear more about that in the days to come, is putting together a LifeBridge Church Resource Center where we would piggyback on things that are already happening in COVID-19. We're putting a lot of leadership into that. And then how do we as a community bless and encourage those who may be suffering, both within our community and those that we know, through a resource center that is available both through our app and through leadership and the things that we can do. And so we're praying and thinking about that. LifeBridge Church, we love you. Your leaders are praying for you. We're thankful for the grace of God, right? The emphasis now in the vision that God has given us, being disciples who are obedient to the call of Jesus Christ. I am thankful for each and every one of you. Lord God, bless us as we continue to seek you out in the mission that you've laid on our heart and the values that are deeply embedded in the Word of God and in the vision for what you have for us in 2020 and beyond. It's not changed. How we go about it has. Father, may we be faithful in the calling for which you have called us. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.